We use a lot of words in the English language for poisons and toxins, toxic, poisonous, venoms. The difference between a poison or a toxin or a venom is often just about how the substance is delivered. Tetrodotoxin, obviously a toxin, is in pufferfish and in the rough-skinned newt, where it's poisonous if you eat either of those. But it's a venom in the blue-ringed octopus because it's delivered with a bite. In terms of being venomous, we tend to think of this as the ability for an animal to overpower a large prey item. And so the payoff is you get a big meal and then enough energy to produce more toxin and go on and do it again and to mate and produce more of your own kind. Pit vipers are a little bit different. It's really about the snake's ability to avoid being eaten by opossums.
Possums feed on pit vipers, or are known to eat pit vipers, and pit viper venom is what's called hemolytic. So it's venom that attacks the circulatory system. So typically, animals that are bitten by pit vipers bleed to death. So what was cool about what Sharon and I were doing is that we found molecular evidence that these animals are resistant to snake venoms.
So snake venoms are very, very complex cocktails of lots of different toxic molecules. And opossums will need a whole array of different ways to neutralize those toxins or not be affected by those toxins. And the work that Rob and I did shed light really on just one particular mechanism where you've actually changed the molecule so that a toxin can no longer bind to it.
Before this, people had been thinking about venom, snake venom, as an adaptation for feeding. And what we're suggesting is that, yes, snakes feed using their venom, but they also defend themselves.
The initial goal was to understand evolutionary relationships among opossums. I never dreamed that I would begin to understand more about snake venoms or how snakes subdue their prey.
Poisonous snakes were not on our radar. You know, we were interested in evolutionary relationships of possums. And that's why Sharon was sequencing genes, and that's why I was studying, you know, possum anatomy. And, you know, but science is like that. You know, you think you're working on one thing, and you find out stuff about something else. You know, and it's one of the reasons, it's one of the justifications for doing pure science.
Just because something is toxic doesn't necessarily make it bad.
A poison can be used for good, or toxins in general, from either poisonous or venomous animals. If you can figure out a way to isolate a single component from the venom as opposed to using the whole venom. So I like to describe cone snails as beautiful small packages that have a wicked deadly punch. And so the proboscis, on the tip of the proboscis, you have a radula or a harpoon, which is filled with venom. It's important to note that the snail does not kill the fish when it injects the venom. It stuns them, so it's not feeling pain. It won't go into fight or flight mode and try to escape. Because why else, I mean, would a slow-moving snail hunt something as fast as a fish? And so in our lab, we'd like to find out, in the venom component, all of the different neuropeptides that are there, where do they go? We know that they work on the nervous system, and so you test them on different components of the nervous system. And then from there, you're trying to pick out which are the ones that are going to be able to be manipulated for good. What are they going to hit inside of the human body that will inhibit either the pain signal, a cardiac signal, in some cases even epileptic signals from going forward. Cone snails are not only showing us new compounds for drug development, but they're also showing us new targets. So when you're thinking about pain management, you don't have to think something that works with opioids, you can think something that works with ion channels, which is really exciting and new.
Rather than come away from this exhibition being afraid of poisons, toxins, and venoms, they'll come away seeing the power of poison in terms of what those organisms, including ourselves, have been able to do to leverage that power to our own advantage. I can make it later.